I'm going to update everybody on some MCR activities that are going to be coming in the next months. Program news, we had our midterm review a year ago and got a lot of really good input and feedback from that. And our site, like everybody else, is trying to make progress toward resolving the 2020 COVID-19 related challenges. We're a very field-based site, so we've got a lot of things to work out in terms of that for MCR. Okay, so we have a new initiative that is emerging pretty rapidly, and this relates to the effects of COVID-19 on coral reef resilience. And with MCR, our central focus is to study the resilience of reefs. And we've been really interested in the processes that drive state shifts between coral and large fleshy algae or seaweeds as alternate states on the reefs in Moorea. When we lose coral from the reefs with following big disturbances, sometimes algae can come in and replace coral as the foundation species. And we've been studying two classes of factors that really affect the proliferation of algae during those recovery periods. The first is, as you can see in the slide, herbivorous fish can graze and browse algae and therefore suppress it during the recovery period. And that can favor the replenishment of coral on the reef. By contrast, nutrient enrichment or nutrient pollution can actually foster the growth of algae and give it an advantage in proliferation on the reef. Now, human activities interact with these processes on Moorea in a couple of really important ways. In terms of fishing, most households in Moorea engage in some level of fishing, and quite a bit of that fishing is targeted toward herbivorous fishes that you see here for sale by the roadside. And obviously, overfishing of herbivores can affect the ability of those fish to control algal proliferation on the reef. In addition, we have quite a bit of tourism activities, including a number of large hotels and a lot of other touristic economy on Moorea, and that can contribute to nutrient enrichment into the lagoons. Now, COVID-19 has been a huge shock to the social system of Moorea. Like elsewhere, the economy is pretty much shut down. Hotels are completely closed and all tourism has been stopped. And this has resulted in quite a bit of job loss, as you can imagine, on the island. And so we're hypothesizing that the collapse of employment might force many households into much enhanced fishing. And this could impact on the herbivorous fish that are available on the reef. By contrast, a positive impact might be resulting from reduced tourism and other kinds of activities that enhance nutrient enrichment on the reef. And actually, we may see a lower supply of nutrients coming onto the reef in the coming months during the shutdown of tourism. So we plan to explore the implications of these shocks to the social system on bottom-up and top-down forcing. Now, I'll tell you about our two strategies to do this. This slide shows you how we are going to look at human behavior from the point of view of fishing. For a number of years, we've conducted detailed studies of fisher behaviors, involving where and when and why people fish, what they catch, and so on and so forth. So we're going to reestablish several of those activities in this period coming up. And one of those is household surveys. And these involve interviews in households where we talk to fishers and we quantify the engagement of the household in fishing and the kinds of fish they target and the amount of fishing that they do. And we're particularly interested in this because a lot of the fishing is spear gun fishing, as you can see in the photo here. And that is critically important to the targeting of herbivorous fish, which are really important in reef resilience. Another thing that we'll be doing is additional roadside fish sale surveys. And in these, we can visit sellers who are selling their catch on the roadside, and we can quantify the taxa and the body sizes of fish that have been taken. And also in our interviews, we can find out what the total catch was and the location of those catches. In addition, we have been working with a set of individual fishers who collect very high resolution spatial data via self-reporting. These fishers take cell phones with them on their forays, and then they record the time and places where they went and also their catch. And on the bottom of the slide, you can see a photo of a map with the fishing track of a fisher who paddled out to fish in the red and then spent several hours fishing back to his home port during the night. In addition, you see the photo of his catch that he had at the end of that bout. So we're going to be able to compare changes in individual fisher behavior as well by looking at our time series of self-reporting fisher data. In addition, we will measure change in the size and the abundance of key herbivorous fish on the reef. Now, from the point of view of nutrients, our goal is to quantify the changes in the amount and the distribution of nitrogen enrichment in the lagoons. And on the left, you can see a map of Moorea with the lagoons surrounding the island. And this is a heat map of nutrient enrichment, nitrogen enrichment, that we've done for the lagoon in our studies of seasonal variation in nutrient enrichment. And not surprisingly, we've been finding that nutrient enrichment is normally great near settlements on the island, large hotels, and off of the major catchments. So our goal is to resurvey the nutrient levels in the absence of tourism and a lot of economic activity on the island, and then during the subsequent return period and ramp up, which we think will be later in 2020 and going into 2021. In addition, we'll follow the spatial dynamics of algae in the lagoon to link with the nutrient enrichment. Now, our hypothesis is that the negative impact via overfishing of herbivorous fish is likely to be a much more powerful feature during this period, and it's likely to outweigh any positive effects of reduced nutrient input to the nearshore marine system. But obviously we don't know the answer to that yet, so more later. Now, just a couple of things about challenges and future science. Obviously we have some challenges. We are seeking funding for some of the immediate social science research tasks. And there's quite a bit of timing uncertainties for our surveys and sample collection. We're in the process of figuring out when are the optimal times to sample things. And some of this obviously depends on the government easing of social restrictions in the country. But there's a lot of scientific potential here, we think. We're hoping to engage with other sites to do comparisons of responses of coupled social-ecological systems to COVID-19. We really always are trying to understand effects of top-down and bottom-up processes in our system. And this research is engaging us at really small spatial scales that really haven't been explored in coral reef ecosystems. And I've seen some really cool examples of increased spatial scales that other sites have been showing the last couple days in talks in their studies of nutrients. So I think there's a lot of potential there for collaboration. And lastly, we really want to compare feedbacks in social ecological systems that result from natural disturbances, which is what we normally think about in Moorea, as opposed to social disturbances, which is what we're having now due to COVID-19. And with that, I will stop.
Thanks, Sally.